I fucks with Brandi L. Bates, yo. I fucks with her. She bad. She bomb. She beautiful. I shit.
You are now tuned in to Power Podcasts, the Empower Hour. Peace and blessings, beautiful souls. I am Brandi L. Bates, author of Moonshine for the Soul, The Art of Grind, and many other books. I'll be your host for tonight. You can find me on Twitter at Soledad Francis and on Instagram at Brandi Is Winning. Most of these podcasts can be found archived on YouTube, hashtag Power Podcasts, but please listen to them while they still have all of their spirit and vitality by subscribing to us on iTunes, Spotify, SoundCloud, and or BrandiBates.podomatic.com. Winning season. It's winning season. It's winning season, a time of manifestation. Your brain is like a computer. It's just like a computer. You are constantly downloading new information. Reboots are happening every day. You're downloading, you're uploading Your true work in life is to keep lifting your frequency. Everything in your life comes as a result of your current vibrational frequency. And I know that I say that a lot. I talk about vibrational frequency and vibes a lot, but it really is at the seat of everything. Keep lifting your frequency and you'll notice yourself drawing in better and better partners, better and better money opportunities, everything, you name it, everything in general. Your heart knows things that your mind cannot explain. The body, the mind, and spirit meet at our pineal gland. So keep that in the back of your mind as you listen to this real quick. The body, mind, and spirit meet at our pineal gland, in our minds. You can't always be happy, but you can always be brave. You can always choose to pick your mindset, your state of mind, your attitude, how you behave in any given situation. You decide if you want to be a bitch, if you want to be an asshole. You decide if you want to be cooperative, to build and not destroy, to uplift, to elevate, to pour into versus to sponge and take and take and take. You get to decide that. We're deciding that every day. All day, every day, in every way, and in every setting we're doing this. That is the beginning of everything. If you feel like, you know, and there are times when this happens to all of us. For some of us, it's feeling like the other. You don't fit in the microcosm of things. You don't fit in this world system. You don't fit in this, you know, the typical what society deems as beautiful or strong or successful or yada yada yada. If you feel like you don't fit in this world, right, you just don't fit into any of the molds, it's because you are here. You're here to help engineer a new one, to help create and bring about and reconfigure this whole thing called life on Earth. The purpose of life is evolution. And you don't have to know a whole lot about history or geography or geology or just studying nations and empires and people, you don't have to go deep into that study to see and realize that all of life is constantly evolving, period. We're bigger than our ancestors used to be. We're doing different things. We're on a whole different vibe, right? We're digital. We are remote. It's a whole different world than it was just 50 years ago, 100 years ago. So, you know, it's a totally different reality 1,000 years ago, right? And it's going to be a totally different reality 20 years from now, 10 years from now. Technology, everything, how we do things is constantly shifting. Keep this in mind. Winning season. We cannot change the world until we change ourselves. Mother Teresa said that. She said, I alone cannot change the world, but I can cast a stone across the waters to create many ripples. And that's such a powerful quote, a powerful saying, because it embodies the message and inspiration of the skipping stone, right? We aim to make an impact, to make ripples in the work that we do. Parents are implanting and embedding certain ideology into children to pass on a certain way of doing things, right? To pass down legacy, to pass down tradition, to pass down, family, very important family information, right? We aim to make an impact. Wherever you are, wherever you dwell, whatever you do for a living, ultimately beyond things out of your control, you're there to make an impact. Always and in all ways. Because all that will matter when you've taken your last breath is how you treated people, the work you did, the work you're currently doing, what you created, what are you creating, what are you building, what are you birthing, and the ripples you have made. Period. That's it. That's it. To change the world, to change the trajectory of this three-dimensional 3D reality, I alone cannot change society for the better. I can't. I'm one person. I'm one woman at that. One woman of color. I cannot move the needle of society. But what I can do is radically transform my own consciousness. You with me? I can dramatically, radically, emphatically transform my own consciousness. See, I have control over that. And I can overturn the condition that limits my potential. Yogananda once said, you must not let your life run in the ordinary way. Do something that nobody else has done. Something that will dazzle the world, right? Show that God's creative principle works in you. What you here to do? What are you here to do? What are you here to do? Why are you here? Why are we here? Why are we here? There is a time, place, reason, and season for everything under the sun. The secret of life is to learn when, where, why, and how. Knowledge is power. Ram Dass once said, information is just bits of data. Knowledge is putting them together. Wisdom is transcending them, right? Knowledge is consciousness of reality. Consciousness of reality. What did I say? Evolution of your consciousness. That's how you manifest shit. There's an ancient Egyptian proverb that says, reality is the sum of the laws that govern nature and of the cause from which they flow. If you didn't know, anger, when you get worked up, you heat it, right? You heat it, you heat it, you heat it, you heat it. You ready to throw hands, right? You mad, right? You big mad. I can't argue with you, right? Mad, anger weakens your liver. Grief, you sad, right? You big sad, right? Grief, you sad. Melancholy, you in your feelings, you in your mood, you right, you in your bag, right? Grief weakens your lungs. Worry weakens your stomach. Over time, if you worry and over years and years and years, it starts to slowly eat away at the lining of your stomach, of your intestinal tract. Yeah. And fear weakens your kidneys, right? And stress weakens your heart and brain, right? Anger weakens your liver. Grief weakens your lungs. Worry weakens your stomach. Fear weakens your kidneys. Stress weakens your heart and brain. What do you think is happening to you as you day in and day out, you're watching the news about COVID-19 and the new spread and the new strain and the deluxe plus strain that's going to kill million, and you constantly are just imbibing negativity and negativity and negativity and negativity and low vibrational programming, right? Even follow me. Why is it that we are attracted to one person and not to others? Why are we attracted to who we are attracted to? Because I believe the heart wants what it wants. We all have our preferences. We all have our types, good, bad, or indifferent. You like what you like, right? Why is it that you are attracted to certain people that have certain features or certain characteristics or certain, you know, they look a certain way, they smell a certain way, they're built a certain way? That's what you like. That's what you like, right? You feeling that, right? Our brain, it all comes down to chemistry, literally. Our brains run a set of chemical calculations every day. You don't even get to think about it. It's involuntary. It's just like, you don't have to think about breathing. Your body, your heart's going to pump for you. You don't have to tell it what to do. You don't control it. Thank goodness, right? Our brains run on formulas, if you will, and on information from all five senses to determine attraction. And so, what that means physically is, first, we identify things that instinctually indicate reproductive fitness, right? Like, you know, for some people, shiny hair, strong hands, big hands, right? Big feet. We're looking at the skin, smooth skin. Is it skin? Is it bumpy? Is it zits? Is it, you know, rashes? Is it clear skin? We like clear skin. Most people, we prefer clear skin. And even facial symmetry. Even, you know, we're starting to see a whole different look because of plastic surgery, because of people getting work done, because they want their face to have a certain symmetry and a certain look and a certain appeal, which causes us, all of this causes us to want to move closer to the person we're attracted to. And so this in turn stimulates the other senses. Our noses, for example, pick up pheromones, right? They pick up pheromones. You smell good. Oh, you smell good. I like some smell good. I love some smell good. Listen, you can just smell good and by default you win, because it's a primal human thing. Even animals, what do animals do when they meet each other? They sniff each other's butts, right? Cats do it, dogs do it. We do it too on a different level. But this is studying and it's checking for certain genetic information. And our ears are attracted to a certain vocal timbre, right? We say, oh, she got a sexy voice. He got a sexy voice. Girl six. Oh, you sound good. You sound sexy. You look, a lot of times, you know, sometimes the look, the face don't match the voice. But that's because we have certain ideas. Genetic information that we're storing in our consciousness. The first kiss is crucial because it acts as an initial exchange of chemical and tactile cues that can determine whether or not someone is a good match. So, for instance, the smell and taste of someone's mouth, that plays a big, huge part, right? Listen, not you fucking with somebody that can't do shit for you, but give you heartache and yeast infections, right? Not you. Attraction. Why are we attracted to certain things? Why are we, I always say, you begin making love to a woman, men and women are different. Men and women are different. Attraction. You start making love to a woman hours before you touch her body. It starts with a text message. It starts with the, you know, throughout the day. And slowly but surely, because mentally, you're affecting the thought world. Stay with me. I'm going somewhere. But all of this is the science of attraction. This is the science of attraction. It's a theme. I promise you. Miguel Ruiz reminds us in his book, The Four Agreements, you express your own divinity. You express your own divinity by being alive and by loving yourself and others. It all comes down to chemistry. When attraction strikes, right? It's because our brains are driven by the pathways associated with rewards. For instance, when we do something that feels good to us, our brain releases dopamine, right? Right? You get online, you get on social media, you see 1,000 likes, that does something for you. For some people, that gets some people dick hard, right? That gets some people wet. It just does something. No judgment, right? It feels good, so we want to do it again, right? Another hormone, norepinephrine, is also released during this stage, and it stimulates our natural fight or flight response, right? Which causes our heartbeats to increase, our pupils dilate, our bodies release glucose for energy, and combined with dopamine, it creates the euphoric feelings that we often experience early on in relationships. That's why we can sometimes feel almost addicted to somebody. Have you ever just been addicted to somebody? Like you just can't get enough of them, right? The attraction stage stimulates the same parts of the brain that cocaine does. Did you know? Yeah. Cocaine. Same sensors, same chemicals, same biology, mindset, thought world. Give yourself the love you seek. Give yourself the love you seek, and the universe will send people who match it. Because see, for a lot of you, you're looking for something. You're looking for a love that you really don't even give yourself, right? You don't even take yourself out. You don't even spoil yourself. You don't even look for the best and the highest and the greatest for yourself. But you want somebody else to give you that. So see, you got the game fucked up. Maya Angelou reminds us, she told us that everything in the universe has a rhythm. Everything has a rhythm. Everything as above, so below. Everything has a rhythm. We see it in the waves. We see it at the ocean. We see it when the breeze blows through the trees. We see it in a storm as it rains. We see it especially in the growth of all trees. We see rhythm, symmetry, patterns. Even congrats and condolences are two sides of the same coin. It's crazy how you could be on your timeline and you're seeing obituaries, and then you're seeing gender reveals and welcome my new daughter or my new son, and then obituaries, same coin. How do you exit virtual reality? See, your brain is your virtual reality headset, and it allows you pure positive energy to enter and experience a world where vibrations and everything is perceived as matter. Everything that you see is just vibrating stuff, energy, waves, particles, right? It looks solid, but everything is in movement. Even your body, even the cells and atoms of our bodies. But it your mind, it allows you to pretend that you are a human being. To pretend that you are black or white or woman or man or Christian or Muslim, right? All these labels and boxes. But see, master teachers remove the virtual reality headset, if you will, whenever they want to. And so they switch off as much of their senses as possible. And some of them do this with meditation. Some of them do it with yoga. Some of them do it with ayahuasca, right? Some of them do it with psilocybin. Some of them do it with prayer. Some of them go into trance. Master teachers, the objective is to perceive without the distortions caused by the virtual reality that you call life. That's going to hit some of you like a month from now. Your brain is your virtual reality software, baby. Your brain is your computer. Everything that happens to you is your teacher. The secret is to learn to sit at the feet of your own life and be taught by it. That heartbreak, how you got shit on. Yeah, remove old boy or old girl who caused it. You got shit on to teach you something. That's a whole university. That's a whole guru. That's a whole holy book. All of your relationships, all of your jobs, all the times you've gotten lost and turned around, every single heartbreak and heartache, all the good times, the people that made you feel loved, the people who actually just rock with you and fuck with you. I always say, I'm just grateful for the people who really rock with me, who really, 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 really rock with me. I'm so grateful for that. That too is a master teacher. That too is a lesson. It's a university. Everything that happens to you is your teacher. Since everything is a reflection of our minds, everything can be changed by our minds, by our words. Speak to the situation. I don't care what it looks like. I don't care what they're telling you. Talk to the situation. It has consciousness. It has memory. If you can master and destroy the 13 enemies you cannot see, egoism, arrogance, conceit, selfishness, greed, lust, intolerance, right? Anger, lying, cheating, gossiping, slandering. If you can master and get a hold of those 13 enemies, you'll be ready to fight the enemy that you can see. See, a lot of shit that's happening to you is because of you. And that's just that on that, right? That's just period. It's you who keeps putting yourself through certain situations. It's you who picked that job. It's you who continues to get up every day and do the same thing day in and day out. It's you who chooses whether you're going to work out or not. It's you. It's us who choose what we put in our mouth. Nobody's forcing you to eat what you eat. No one forcing you to smoke or drink or anything. It's us. The biggest enemy is in me. Your biggest hater really are the words you tell yourself. It's who you were or who is trying to keep you at your current level and condition. Not some monster, not some demon, not some horned monster. It's the shit that's going on in between our two ears, baby. Do you hear me? Marianne Williamson said, until we have met the monsters in ourselves, we will keep trying to slay them in the outer world, for all darkness in the world stems from the darkness in the heart. And it's there we must do our work, baby. It ain't no shit outside of us. It's us. That's what we need to deal with. See, first you have to ascend to the point of true self-mastery before you experience pure manifestation. You know, you've mastered a soul lesson when the circumstance hasn't changed, but the way you respond has changed, the way you look at it. See, sometimes before you can really see your life upgrade and move to the next level, you got to take it for just what it is. The same hoopty you driving, you going to get better. Better is coming. But you know what? In the meantime, let's take care of the one we have. Let's take care of it. Let's keep it clean. Let's keep it, taken care of. Let's keep it in good working condition because we're grateful for it, right? Wherever you are living, that may not be where you want to be. But guess what? You just be grateful for it because shit could be a lot worse. We good with it, right? You got a roof over your head. You got clean water. So I say all that to say, you got to change how you look at the situation. You got to find harmony and bliss and heaven between your two ears, right where you are, in the house that you live in the apartment, you, wherever, how small it is. I don't care where it's located. I don't care if you're in the middle of the fucking jungle. In your mind, you got to be good with where you are and how things are and find the harmony and the happiness in the moment. And slowly you move to change how that looks. But you got to be good with you. Repeat after me. I am stepping into the most successful decade of my life. I am stepping into the most successful decade of my life. And repeat this affirmation to yourself each and every day. Do it for at least 90 days. 3 times in the morning, 6 times during the day, 9 times at night before you go to bed. 3, 6, 9. Learn how to program your DNA and your internal central processing unit. And so before you change anything in your life, you got to clean up your psychology. Real talk. See, too many of us have a love-hate relationship with ourselves, with our past, with our extreme attachment to outcomes, and even unrealistic expectations. How many? You just got unrealistic expectations. You know, shit just really ain't gonna happen like that. Right? Hope for the best, but be real with yourself in the sense that you know the reality of where you are. You've got to keep it a buck with yourself. Everything that happens to us is the result of what we ourselves have thought, said, or done. We alone are responsible for our lives. Confucius said, let the state of equilibrium and harmony exist in perfection, and a happy order will prevail throughout heaven and earth, and all things will be nourished. Why? Because consciousness influences the behavior of subatomic particles, which in turn make up everything in the universe. The future is not something we enter. We don't enter the future. The future is something we create. We're creating the future right now. Everything you're saying and doing is building your tomorrow. Everything you're eating and drinking and sniffing and snorting and breathing in is building the muscles, your hair, your eyebrows, your fingernails, all of that is being built from the shit you're taking in today. See, your greatest work is to understand how your thoughts, your consciousness, the level of your thought world, your vibrational frequency and wavelength determines your current reality. Anything you think about again and again and again affects your feelings. And it impresses upon the subconscious mind, and it becomes part of your personality. The mind is a fertile garden, so you gotta nurture it wisely.